Of an act, o creed, the tears that later, a humble giving, is the divine to work, dull though I fail, a humble giving, the rohan yalas, the kail to crevach, the glaun to malas, the vaun to lere. O gram o cri I tzud le chele, a cham.
To look down the street, you could see, you had sea and the mountains as well. But I thought that was the greatest view that I really saw at the time of my life.
Well, it was Market Square, first of all, and then it became Devonshire Square. And of course, Devonshire Square became Grattan Square. I think when a lot of people walk through Dungarvan, they just walk through shops and houses. For me, I suppose I'm walking through history. I'm walking on the causeway where my granduncle laboured across it when he was drunk.
When I was growing up, every house nearly had a family in it. But today there's not even half a dozen, like, in the whole square.
There was eight of us, but never really all at the same time. It was when you're the youngest, the eldest ones have gone off to wherever they're going to be, you know, teacher training school or wherever they've gone off to. And then, so there was still the boys, three boys in an eternally smelly room at the back of the house overlooking the Cumber Mountains.
Like everybody else, all our mothers and fathers wanted was the best for us. And once there's a fire in the grate and food on the table.
Like, when I was growing up, I knew everybody in the town. I knew all the children, the grandfathers, the grandmothers, the mothers and the fathers. But today it's kind of all changed. I don't know anyone like today.
We never had luxuries, but we were never hungry and we were never cold. Or
all the people that grew up with me, there's no competition. Even though there was the rich children, the girls' children we thought were very rich, and then there was managers' children.
Like, at that time, everybody watched out for everybody, you know what I mean? It was a great thing, really, like, you know. Or if they could help out in any way, if they're doing something, a job in the house or something like that, they'd help out, like, you know.
They worked from dawn until dark. They'd be knitting at the fire, stockings, and they'd get all their wool in Mulcahy's and Dungarvan. It's a drapery shop.
All I can remember when I was young, my parents were always working. When my mum used to come in, she was always washing, ironing, baking.
But Dungarvan wasn't as built up, of course, and it was very easy to access the country. You know, there was a place called the Mills out 2 miles outside town. I mean, there was always, every day, we were kind of going, where will we go? What will we do? Will we cross that stream?
Played a lot of skippet and take a blind man's buff and all that.
Across the road from here now, we had a physical culture club, weightlifting club, and I was in that too and did a lot. We used to go up and climb the Cumbers and right up to the very top and over back into Ballymacarbery. We did all these sort of things with nothing else.
Well, I've been fishing since I was a child. My older sister, Mary, and myself used to go down the Mahon River when we were very, very young, bring down a sandwich, and my mother used to make homemade lemonade. And we'd have that with us down all day. And you know, you're safe then.
As soon as I got a bicycle, then I was cycling out to Colligan in particular. And I had a friend out there who actually worked in the bakery, so I'd cut into her house and have a cup of tea and a bit of apple tart, and then go on up the woods and up to the Salmon Lip in particular, which was just a really wild place. Like,
the lighting used to go off at 12 o'clock in the night, so after 12 o'clock you'd see nothing. So the whole town used to, just the lights used to go off at 12 o'clock. So you'd hear people outside and they'd be singing away and talking, all right, but you wouldn't see them.
My sister, Walburga, is sitting on top of Jimmy Foley's donkey and trap, and that then is tied to the old lamppost that was across the way, and it was one of the few electric lights that was around the town, that one there, and that was always kept lighting.
I remember coming in with my mother, we'll say, down the lookout there, which is looking across onto the Conigar. There used to be a swimming pool down there.
I was in the swimming club in Dungarvan. It was 2 shillings to join. I had to do jobs for my mother to get the 2 shillings.
It was an open-air tidal pool, and that was magic. And that existed for many years. It was built before I was born, and it continued up into the 80s, I think the early 80s.
That when high tide was coming in, they'd open up the sluice gates, all the water would come in, they'd close the sluice gates before the tide would turn, and the pool was kept full of water. And they'd empty the pool every so often and give it a washout and that. But that's where the lads would spend their days down there swimming. I tried to learn to swim there, but I just couldn't. I used to hate the place. Because